we are Sumitalak and we are here to explain body fluids and circulation. Friends, in this chapter, we are going to discuss about blood, double circulation, regulation of cardiac activity, and disorders of circulatory system. Let us discuss, first of all, before going into the topic, let us know what is meant by body fluids. Body fluid is a special fluid which is present inside the body and helps to transport water, essential elements and nutrients. So most commonly used body fluid in our body is blood, and most of the higher organisms also use blood only. So let us discuss blood. Blood is a special connective tissue which consists fluid matrix, plasma and formed elements. So in blood, let us discuss plasma. Plasma constitutes 55% of blood. And in plasma, there are three major proteins. These are very important in NEET point of view, guys, because in 2018 NEET, a question is framed on these proteins and their functions. Let us see what are they. Three proteins are fibrinogens, globulins, albumins. So let us discuss what function they do. Fibrinogens help in coagulation of blood, globulins help in defense mechanism, albumins help in osmotic balance. Guys, these proteins are very important in NEET point of view, so all of you concentrate on these three proteins. And let us discuss formed elements. Formed elements constitute 45% of blood. There are three types in formed elements. They are erythrocytes, thrombocytes and leukocytes. Let us discuss what are they and what percentages they constitute. Erythrocytes. Erythrocytes are commonly known as red blood cells. They constitute 5 to 5.5 million in a healthy person, whereas thrombocytes constitute 1,50,000 to 3,50,000 in a normal person. In formed elements, leukocytes are very important in examination point of view, guys, because up to now in NEET, they didn't frame any question on leukocytes, but there is a scope to ask this year. So all of you concentrate on leukocytes. Let us see what percentages they constitute. Leukocytes are divided into two types, granulocytes and agranulocytes. So granulocytes are divided into three types, neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, and agranulocytes are divided into two types, lymphocytes and monocytes. Let us discuss what are they. And lymphocytes constitute 60 to 65%, whereas eosinophils constitute 2 to 3% and basophils constitute 0.5 to 1%. And agranulocytes are two types, right? So let us discuss what are they. Lymphocytes constitute 20 to 25% and monocytes constitute 6 to 8%. Guys, these are very important because up to now they didn't ask in NEET, but there is a scope to ask this year. So concentrate on these five types. And let us discuss second topic, double circulation. Before going into the double circulation, let us discuss the structure of heart. So the study of heart and its function is known as cardiology. So we all like cardiology, right? Before going into that, let us discuss some basic structure. Okay, this is a heart structure, and heart is mesodermally derived organ which is located in the thoracic cavity between the two lungs and slightly tilted towards the left. Our heart consists four chambers. Two small upper chambers are known as atriae and two large lower chambers are known as ventricles. There is a thin muscular wall between the two atria known as interatrial septum. And there is a thick muscular wall in between the two ventricles. It is known as interventricular septum. Not only between the ventricles and atries, guys, there is a septum on same side chambers which divides these right atrium and right ventricle is known as thick fibrous tissue. It is known as atrioventricular septum. So all of you concentrate on these septums. These are very important in NEET point of view, guys. And in heart, there are two types of walls. One is cuspid walls and second one is semilunar walls. Cuspid walls are divided into two types, tricuspid and bicuspid. So these tricuspid, bicuspid and semilunar walls are very important in examination point of view, guys, because in 2018 NEET, a question is framed on these walls and their locations. Let us see what are they. Tricuspid wall is located in between the right atrium and right ventricle. So this is tricuspid wall, right? It is located in between the right atrium and right ventricle. Bicuspid wall is located between the left atrium and left ventricle. So this is bicuspid wall, right? Left atrium and this is left ventricle, located in between these both. And semilunar wall is located in between the ventricles and pulmonary arteries and aorta. Pulmonary arteries we can see here. So this ventricle opens through pulmonary artery like this, and here semilunar wall will be present. So it present in between the ventricles and pulmonary arteries and aorta. Okay guys, and in right atrium there are two patches of tissues. They are very important in knee point of view, guys. All of you concentrate on it. So let us discuss what are they. The right upper corner of the right atrium is known as sinoatrial node, and left lower corner of the right atrium is atrioventricular node. Sinoatrial node is called as pacemaker of the heart because it has the ability to generate the action potentials without any external stimuli. So this is very important in knee point of view, guys. And our heart is known as autorhythmic because it can generate its own potentials without any external stimuli. So now let us discuss structure of ECG. That means ECG. ECG means electrocardiogram. Electrocardiogram is a machine which helps to measure electrocardiograph. So electrocardiograph can be represented as a graphical representation which indicates the electrical activity of heart during cardiac cycle. So here we can represent as waves. So there are three types of waves: P wave, Q, R, S and T wave. P wave represents the depolarization of atria, and Q, R, S complex represents the depolarization of ventricles, and T wave represents the repolarization of ventricles. Guys, these waves are very, very, very important in knee point of view, because in 2019 a bit asked in on these waves and what function they do. So depolarization of atria means contraction of atria. Depolarization of ventricles means here not contraction of ventricles, but it initiates the contraction of ventricles. In T wave, the depolarization of ventricles means the completion of ventricle systole takes place. And when this T wave gets reduced, then it indicates that the disorder known as coronary ischemia. So all of you concentrate on these waves. These are very important in examination point of view, guys. Let us discuss cardiac cycle. To understand cardiac cycle, we are dividing into four divisions, guys: joint diastole, atrial systole, ventricle systole and ventricle diastole. In joint diastole, the four chambers of heart are at relaxed state. Both cuspid walls are open and the blood flows directly into the ventricles. So 70% of ventricles get filled in this stage only. 70% of ventricles get filled in the joint diastole only. So let us discuss atrial systole. In atrial systole, the SAR node generates impulses which makes the contraction of both atria. Okay, SAR node generates impulses which makes the contraction of both atria. Then the atria possess some pressure which the blood flows forcefully into the ventricles, and remaining 30% of blood fills in the ventricles in this process. And let us move to ventricle systole. In ventricle systole, pressure increases in the ventricles, and by increasing the pressure in ventricles, the sudden closure of cuspid walls takes place, because to prevent the backflow of blood into the atria. So by the closure of cuspid walls, it produces the first sound of heart. It is first sound of heart and it is known as loud sound. Guys, loud sound is the first sound of heart, so keep concentrating on this topic also. And when after the pressure increases, when semilunar walls get closure, simultaneously here semilunar walls get open. When cuspid walls get closed, simultaneously semilunar walls get open and blood flows into the semilunar walls. That means the blood flows into the pulmonary arteries. From each ventricle, 70 ml of blood flows into the pulmonary arteries. It is known as stroke volume. After this, let us discuss ventricular diastole. In ventricular diastole, the both arteries are at relaxed state. And cuspid walls are open, the pressure decreases in the ventricles, and here we get completed of cardiac cycle, guys. The total duration of cardiac cycle is 0.8 seconds. So let us discuss double circulation. Guys, do you know the father of double circulation? The father of circulation is William Harvey. He identified the double circulation in humans and other organisms. So let us discuss this. This is lungs, heart and body parts, that means tissues. So let us discuss from where blood passes into which chamber of the heart and which chamber it passes into the lungs. From lungs again it comes to which chamber and which chamber it comes into the blood body. So let us discuss all these. This is right atrium, right? From this right atrium, deoxygenated blood flows into the lungs through pulmonary artery. From right ventricle, deoxygenated blood flows into the lungs through pulmonary artery. Okay? And in lungs, it get purified. That means it get oxygenated and it transported to the left atria through pulmonary vein. So hence, this is oxygenated blood. So all this process is known as pulmonary circulation. Guys, we have to concentrate here is in pulmonary artery, deoxygenated blood is transported, whereas in pulmonary veins, oxygenated blood is transported. And let us discuss another circulation. From left atria, the oxygenated blood flows into the body parts, and from body parts, deoxygenated blood is collected through vena cava and it's sent into the right atrium. So we have to observe here is, this circulation is known as systemic circulation. We have to observe here is, from vena cava, deoxygenated blood is transported, whereas from dorsal aorta, oxygenated blood is transported. So we have to concentrate these two differentiations, guys, from which deoxygenated blood is transported and from which oxygenated blood is transported. And let us discuss regulation of cardiac activities. Regulation of cardiac activities is also very important in need point of view, guys, because our heart is regulated intrinsically. Hence, our heart is known as myogenic. There is a special nerve system in medulla oblongata which moderates the cardiac functions is known as autonomic nervous system. Autonomic nervous system is divided into two types. It is sympathetic nervous, it is part of autonomic nervous system, and parasympathetic nerve, it is the component of autonomic nervous system. So let us discuss what function they do. Sympathetic nervous is a part of autonomic nervous system which increases the rate of heartbeat and it increases the cardiac output, increases the strength of ventricular contraction. Okay, I will repeat once again. Sympathetic nerves are part of autonomic nervous system which increases the rate of heartbeat and which increases the cardiac output and it increases the strength of ventricular contraction. So guys, not only sympathetic nerve increases the cardiac output, but there is a hormone which increases the cardiac output. That hormone is adrenal medullary hormone, which increases the cardiac output. So let us discuss another parasympathetic nerves. Parasympathetic nerves are the components of autonomic nervous system which decreases the heart rate and decreases the cardiac output and it decreases the speed of conduction of action potentials. So guys, again I am repeating. Parasympathetic nerves is the component of autonomic nervous system which decreases the rate of heartbeat and cardiac output and it decreases the speed of conduction of action potentials. So, last topic but not least, it is disorders of circulatory system. These are very important, guys, in need point of view. There is a scope to ask from disorders also. So, let us all concentrate on this topic. First of all, let us discuss high blood pressure. High blood pressure is also known as hypertension. So in a normal person, high blood pressure is 140. In a normal person, blood pressure is 120 by 80 mmHg. So this 120 represents the systolic pressure, whereas 80 represents the diastolic pressure. If it reaches to 140 by 90, it signifies that the person or that girl or that boy having higher hypertension. This leads to the disorders in heart, as well as it affects some vital organs like brain and kidneys. Once again, I will repeat. 120 by 80 is normal blood pressure. If it reaches to 140 by 90, it says that that person or that guy or anyone is having higher hypertension. So it leads to the diseases in the heart, as well as it affects some vital organs like brain, kidneys. So let us discuss second one, coronary artery disease. This coronary artery disease is also known as arteriosclerosis, which affects the vessels that supply blood to the heart muscles. Due to the deposition of calcium, fats, cholesterol and fibrous tissue. Once again, I am repeating, guys. Coronary artery disease is also known as arteriosclerosis, which affects the blood vessels that supply blood to the heart. Next, angina pectoris. Angina pectoris is commonly known as angina. When a person is affected with this disease, we get the symptom acute chest pain due to the lack of oxygen supplying to the heart muscles. We can see this disease in middle agers and in elders. Heart failure. Heart failure means when heart is not pumping effectively. That means when heart is not pumping blood effectively to the body parts, then we get this heart failure disorder. Next, heart arrest. Heart arrest means the heart stop beating is known as heart arrest. That means heart stops beating. Heartbeat stops. So it is known as heart arrest. Now our last topic is heart attack. Heart attack means the sudden damage of vessels due to inadequate blood supply is known as heart attack. We can see this heart attack in any age people, because there is no age limit for heart attack. Guys, by this topic we get end of my chapter, and all the best for your NEET exam, guys. But this chapter is very important to NEET, and all of you concentrate on this topic, because before last year we got 2 bits from this topic, that this and this, but last year we got 1 bit from this topic on waves. So this year there is a scope to ask 2 to 3 bits or 1 bit or 2 bits. To all of you concentrate, don't negligate it. And this topic is very important. So RVM's Medical Academy wishing you all the best for your NEET examination. Thank you.